Can you imagine a street festival in Chinatown without alcohol? Well, that's what some Chinatown residents and business owners are hoping for, and they've even started a petition. Vanessa Stewart joins us now with more. Vanessa.
Marissa, those who signed the petition say the alcohol served at street festivals are having a negative effect. It's gotten so bad it's causing people to avoid Chinatown.
Some Chinatown residents and business owners are fed up and have signed a petition to ban alcohol at all street festivals. They say in recent years, the street festivals have become too chaotic and it's driving customers away.
What we'd like to do is really take the alcohol out of the street festival so that people are calmer and saner, and then when they drink, and they want to buy a drink, go into the bars.
Schubert Kwok says although the festivals are attracting more people to Chinatown, only some businesses are benefiting from the events.
People that are planning to come to the restaurant are not coming into the restaurant because it's too blocked, too crowded, and there's no parking. So it hurt the businesses when we have festival, contrary to what people think.
First Friday is one of the popular events in Chinatown. Some business owners say it started as a family event, but drastically changed over the years.
Now it's mostly about drinking. It's like you come to Chinatown on First Friday to drink.
Oswald says it's gotten so bad sometimes that he's had to clean up vomit outside his store after a street festival.
Now the families that used to come down on First Friday, they don't want to come down here to see girls throwing up.
Melanie Yang works at Peggy Hopper Gallery and says she's seen nothing but positive effects from First Friday.
We still continue to have the gallery open on First Friday, and we still have an influx of visitors to see the artwork.
She says up to 200 people will visit the gallery during First Friday.
I do notice that it does bring in a lot of people who wouldn't necessarily come down here, and exposing them to a very historic area of Honolulu.
The Chinatown Business and Community Association plans to submit the petition to Mayor Carlisle on Monday. Vanessa Stewart, KHON 2 News, Hawaii's news leader.